the thing they talk about, readers or leaders, you know, that is so true. And now with technology, we don't have to be readers anymore. We just have to have a good phone that has Audible on it. And you can almost effectively read anything out there. And there's so many smart people. And I was in the service, and I read a book on goal setting. So I was literally less than 21, because I got out of the service when I was 21. I had 4 years in by the time I was 21. But it was about goal setting. And it's like, when I read that book, the thing I remember the most is I felt like I had control over my life when I did the goal setting. That was probably the biggest takeaway. Is it's like, if you have goal setting, you can have dreams, you can realize those dreams, and there's probably really nothing you can't accomplish. In fact, you're probably not going to dream big enough. You know, you're not going to set that big, hairy, audacious goal. In fact, that's called a BHAD. If you ever see those letters, that's big, hairy, audacious goal. And most of us aren't brave enough to have those goals. And I'll admit I was one of them. I just wanted to, like, I think like everybody else, like get the first house, make the first. And I didn't have the courage to think past that first house. I just wanted to figure out how to do that. But, you know, goal setting is good because it re-inspires you and it gives you hope and gives you passion. And so to me, goal setting has always been important. Have I always been good at it? No, but I don't give up. I'm too dumb to give up. So I just keep plugging away and plugging away. It's like the smoking. They said that the average smoker has to try 7 times before they're successful. So my way of thinking is like, how do you try 7 times as quick as possible?
I quit every day.
When you're unconscious, huh?